Hello everyone, I Dushyant Shekhawat welcome you all. Today, in this module, we will learn about bombs and IEDs, that is, improvised explosive device. We will understand everything in detail, that is, IED, components, working, types, counter IED equipments and measures, and at last, conclusion. So, what is an IED? An IED is a bomb constructed and deployed in ways other than in conventional military action. It is a bomb fabricated in an improvised manner incorporating destructive, lethal chemicals. So, components of IED are explosive, detonator, electric wire, and power source.
How IEDs work? Power source supplies electricity to wire, which activates the detonator and main charge explodes, producing high pressure shock waves. Moving to types of IEDs, first we have command wire IED, which is initiated by electric cable or wire which is attached to battery and is often buried under rods, walls and buildings, and therefore it is very difficult to detect. Second is radio control IED, which is an IED initiated electronically in a wireless manner consisting of a transmitter and a receiver. For example, phone, pager, walkie-talkie, car alarm, doorbell, etc. Radio control IEDs are initiated by a radio link. Next is victim operated IEDs. These IEDs function on contact with their victims, and these are well hidden from victim or disguised as everyday household items like Pepsi can, Tiffin boxes, pressure plates, etc. When object is moved, the IED switch is triggered. Next is suicide bomb IEDs, which is carried by a suicide bomber. Some suicide vests have secret radio control IEDs, which the handler can detonate if the suicide bomber backs out. Next is passive infrared IEDs, which uses a laser infrared beam as a trigger mechanism and which is almost undetectable. Passive infrared IEDs trigger detects a change in thermal or infrared energy. The sensors are wired to an arming device. Now we will discuss counter IED equipments and measures. First is jammer, which is used to prevent wireless activation from different distances. The jamming signal is designed to be stronger than the bomb maker's transmitter signal to block the bomber's ability to communicate with this device. This can also be carried along with vehicle within a convoy. But these can only counter remotely detonated IEDs. Second is explosive vapor detector, which is used to detect explosive vapors and traces while searching indoors, sealed packets and in post-blast investigation. Trace detection involves the chemical detection of explosive by collecting and analyzing tiny amount of explosive vapor. Next is non-linear junction detector, which detects the presence of electronics regardless of whether they are radiating, hardwired or even turned off. It detects physical property and not energy emissions. Therefore, devices that contain circuit boards and their components like cell phone, video camera, microphone can be detected. Next is telescope manipulator. This is designed to handle IED from a standoff distance. It is electrically operated mechanical grab with telescopic arm, which can lift up to 10 kg from distance. Now moving to aerostates, these are balloons equipped with infrared and radar sensor, which are manned 24 hours a day. Aerostate provides real-time HD images of surrounding area day or night and are strategically placed for surveillance purpose. Images and audios captured by the balloons are sent electronically through secure system to mobile monitoring station. Now next is electronic stethoscope. It consists of a sensor, an amplifier and a headset. It is integrated with detection sensor, which can detect mechanical movements or certain electronic components which are often found in IEDs, that is mobile phone, digital watch, etc. It can detect mechanical movements through wall, bricks, glass, wood, etc. Signals received by a sensor are fed to the amplifier with stepless adjustable filters which make signals audible in headset. Next comes robots. These are used to inspect a suspicious package during any exercise from a distance and provide continuous data and video feedback. Now comes dozer or IED resistant vehicle. It is used as frontline vehicle for route clearance and it protects crew from bomb explosions and gunfires. Next is bomb disposal suit, which provide high degree of safety while handling an IED and protection from blast effect. Next is bomb blanket, which helps in absorption of shock and impact through protective layers. And at last in this list comes dog, which also helps us in tracking the location of IED. So with this, we have briefly understood IED working and types of IED and countermeasures.
The ultimate goal of management is to ensure a secure and safe workplace. And to achieve this, it is necessary that we, being a security professionals, are continually updating our knowledge, keeping up with the current trends. With this, I, Dushyant, take your leave and I will be back soon with another module. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.